Hey guys, how's it going? Welcome back to the channel. In today's video, I'm going to be unboxing and setting up a new GPU in my PC. The GPU I decided to buy is the MSI 4060 Ti, and this is their Gaming X model. So in this video, it's going to be pretty simple. I'm going to unbox the new GPU, and then I'm going to swap it out with the GPU that's currently in my PC. And then after that, I'm going to have some before and after benchmark results to see what kind of increase of performance I actually got. So other than that, I guess let's just begin. Okay, so here is the box the GPU comes in. So it's pretty much your standard box. So I bought this GPU at Best Buy and it was around $410. This GPU was on clearance. So I think the list price was about like $380. I'll throw some images up pretty much showing what it was before I bought it. So let's open this up. Go. All right, let's flip this over. Take these little tabs out. And then, okay. Flip it back over. Try to pull this thing out. And I don't have enough room, so I gotta throw some stuff on the ground. And here it is. Well, it's in here, so let's open this up. So here is the GPU, and it looks pretty nice. So let me double check to make sure everything's out of the box. Just your instruction guide and then boom. Okay, so before I install the GPU into my computer, I'm just gonna do a quick little overview of it. So yes, this is an MSI 4060 Ti and it has 8 GB of DDR6 memory. And this is their Gaming X model. So down on the bottom right here, you have 2 decently sized cooling fans. And I'm actually surprised how big they are. And then you actually have 2 spots where it has RGB light in. And it kind of carries over to the side right here. So the MSI logo and their dragon light up. There's probably a way to control it within like the BIOS or some other program you can download to pretty much change the light into what you want. So right here is where you would install your PCIe cable and it's an 8-pin. And it's kind of recessed into the card, which is kind of weird. I'm not used to seeing something like that. And then on the back right here is where you have 3 ports for DisplayPort cables, and then you have 1 for HDMI cable. And that's pretty much it. So let me pull my computer out and I will install this. Okay, so the first thing I did was pretty much power down my computer, then unplugged everything so nothing's plugged in currently. So removing the old GPU is pretty simple. I just gotta unplug the PCIe cable right here. This has this little weird adapter for the NVIDIA GPUs, which I don't think I'm going to have to use because it's actually too small to fit into the new one. So I'm just going to set this off to the side. So the only thing that's holding the GPU in is I got 2 screws right here. And I'm going to undo these real quick. Come on. Okay. And then there's actually a pin that's in the motherboard that's pretty much holding it into place. Let me get on this side so I'm not really blocking it. Kind of have to reach your hand back here and find it. And I just tapped it. So now all I just gotta do is pull it straight out like that. And this thing's still warm. And as you can see, the size difference is completely different, but this cord is actually a lot lighter than this one is, which is very strange. I believe it's because it has all this weird aluminum stuff on the side right here that kind of weighs it down. So I'm actually going to set this off to the side. I will be installing this GPU in my daughter's computer so she can have a newer one. And then all I got to do here is take this little cover off right there. Now let me get back to the other side. And then I'm just going to slide it right into its spot. And you should hear a click. Well, not really a click, but it's in there. So I'm going to take the 2 screws I had before and put them pretty much right back in the same spot.
that should hold it into place. And then I can take my PCIe cable. It's actually kind of stuck in there. And then make sure I have the 8 pins. And then I just got to make sure I have it facing the right way, which right now I think it's upside down. It's actually taking longer than I thought it was going to. Okay, that's pushed in there. Then I'm going to tuck the cable back down there so it looks nice again. And that's pretty much it. So I'm going to grab my power cable real quick so I can plug it in so I can see what the RGB lights look like. Okay, so I installed the power cable into the back of the computer. I'm going to power this on. So now I'm just going to hit the power button on top right here. And now let's see what these RGB lights look like. And it looks like you get the rainbow effect going on. Doesn't look too bad. I'm just checking to see if the fans are spinning down on the bottom, which they are. So that looks pretty good. So now I'm just going to put my cover back on and then plug all the cables back in. And then I'm going to update the drivers to the GPU and then I can do my benchmarking. Okay, so now I'm going to install all the new drivers, which I'm just going to do this real quick. And hopefully it shouldn't have any issues. And now I'm just going to let it pretty much do its thing. Okay, so here is the program I like to use. It's called NovaBench, and it kind of does a little full system scan. So anything from your CPU, GPU, memory, and your storage, it gives a score based on that. And as you can see, I ran it 2 hours ago, and I got 3635. So I am just hoping for anything above this. I'm kind of hoping for at least 10% gain, but I guess we'll find out. So all you got to do is just pretty much hit start, and we're just going to let this cook. Okay, so after running this test, I got a score of 3860, which I was actually kind of hoping for more. My GPU score actually jumped up a good bit, but overall with the full system, it actually wasn't that good. I did the percentage over here is only about a 6% gain. So maybe over time and after some like driver updates and stuff like that, this score will go higher, but it is what it is. So the only way I'm going to actually tell how good this card is pretty much playing some games and stuff like that and see if I have any issues. And if I do, I'll leave them down in the comments. But other than that, I guess this video is pretty much done.
So that's going to be it for today's video, and I hope you enjoyed. And if you did, please drop a like. Make sure you're subscribed to the channel for more content. And also, there'll be some affiliate links down in the description. If you wanted to click those to help support my channel, you can do that as well. Pretty much any money I make off those affiliate links gets reinvested back into the channel so I can buy more products to review. So thanks for watching, and I will see you guys in the next one.